Everybody queue up video 17.
Keeps jingling their keys around.
That would be me.
What do you have keys
for? You don't see it here, but I'm actually lying on my back in the middle of the floor, and I keep like trying to bat at the air because I think that the key.
Oh my god, I wish it was.
I haven't heard this since that whole Officer Tenpenny thing.
I'm just picturing you, like, laying on the floor with your legs and hands in the air.
Like, I just don't care.
So don't. All right, come on. Come on!
Okay.
Three, okay.
Two, one, start.
Fuck you, Dad.
Fuck you, Dad.
You can't make me smoke weed.
Look, I mean, like, there's only one way to rebel. I mean, I guess I could, like, just...
smoke weed.
I mean, I guess I could, like, just go straight to crack.
You can just start doing every other drug you can get your hands on, which, in Texas, it's all of them.
Well, actually, primarily, wouldn't it be meth out there? Maybe yep. You should start setting up a moonshine still or something.
I'm sure you would approve of that.
I don't think you should do meth unless you like having a face full of holes.
True story, when I was a kid, my dad...
Oh, wait, she did say that she got her ear pierced recently.
No, I want to hear about the moonshine still.
That's
what
face appendage is.
Okay.
My dad drank moonshine when he had a toothache. He said it was the best.
Is your dad like Stinky Pete the Prospector?
Oh my god, your dad is voiced by Kelsey Grammer? That's awesome, except when he crashes his motorcycle into you.
You don't have a lot of confidence in your... Uh-oh.
Whoa. Oh.
And somehow,
his head
you know,
would
I
be
flipped a
like...
convertible over, I'm still alive.
You don't seem to understand. You don't seem to understand it. It's a very, very tough hat.
You don't seem to have
much confidence. If this was San Andreas, that car would have exploded and a tire would have hit you and you would have, like, gotten caught underneath it and then been busted.
Or at this point,
I guess that guy didn't realize until after he got out of the car that he had a bullet in his brain.
Or,
oh shit, I'm dead!
Nico would have, like, vanished and then the mission failed thing would come up and turns out he was already dead. But was still running around for some reason.
When Bruce Willis was dead, I gave a sixth sense I cheesed in my past.
Wow, we did not, like, follow the tune at all.
True stories. True confessions of...
But you see, the thing was that Nico actually was dead the entire time, but he was, like, an overflow error because he was still being overbuffed by a medic or something. I don't know.
Then who carried out all those murders? Oh my god, it was us, the player.
This LP is actually a marketing tie-in for Avatar.
No, this LP is actually a David Fincher movie.
What?
You know David Fincher, the guy who directed The Game and Seven and other such mind-bending thrillers?
Nope,
never seen any of them.
I saw part of Seven, but it was on TBS, so I think some of it was edited out.
Yeah, there's a lot of
it was only
there.
Five.
What did you do other than Seven?
The Game and Fight Club and The Curious Case of Benjamin Button.
I remember that movie. It was gay.
I thought it was actually quite
good. That it was the by Curious Case of Benjamin Button.
That's the porn version.
The by Curious Case of Benjamin Butt Sex.
Benjamin Bottom.
That's good.
I wonder if Benjamin Bucksex wore apple bottom jeans.
Benjamin Booner.
If you need help with anything, Nico, just speak to me. If you want to get some
Come on, tell me all about the illegal activities you're engaging in.
Well, Michelle,
not involving crime, are you?
It is funny you should mention getting things off my chest. I am having mastectomy next week.
I have different kind of unloading on my mind. The unloading of bullets into many brains.
Michelle, I'm burdened so much by this white privilege.
I have recently read Rudyard Kipling and everything. Stop, fucking damn it. He told the joke I was going to tell.
Too slow.
No, I was actually talking about Rudyard Kipling, so I was too detailed. Hello, beautiful.
Apparently shooting a hooker in broad daylight out in the middle of Liberty City is not a crime.
It was not a hooker.
I think she just had a low cut
top. It was the Sun Girl.
What? Rob Trump was a low cut top, then in my book you're a hooker.
She was too cute.
Not ice cream truck.
Islam is the light.
It's the Puritan run of...
Oh, you know what? I just realized that might be offensive if anybody, like... whatever, fuck it.
Yeah, Roosevelt suddenly becomes concerned about what both reckons. I don't think so.
On a very special episode.
You know, we have a lot of fun in these LPs. Let me tell you about something that's not funny.
Crack!
That's weak.
Shooting hookers in faces. And mistaking sluttily dressed women for hookers.
Every year, 25 women are mistaken for hookers and shot in the face.
By cops.
Nico, it's your cousin.
Zero tolerance! Holy crap, did you see that building pop in right there?
I have different kind of drinking on my mind. The drinking of all the melting ice cream in the back of this truck.
I have different kind of drinking on my mind. The supposed drinking of cum that I am apparently doing. Because he's going on a date with a gay guy.
Oh, okay.
Oh no, your love level with Roman has gone down. You're not going to get the coveralls or whatever vehicle unlock. Something.
I assume
stop
you're
it.
Not going to do
How come every time you're in a video, it becomes a disaster that's somehow still hilarious?
That's Roosevelt.
That's Roosevelt.
Nigger knobs.
I think I almost said that in public the other day.
It's a good thing you didn't.
I know. I was really glad that I didn't say that.
What were you trying to say?
I can't remember. I just remember the thought crossing my mind and then realizing that it was not a good idea.
I meant to say nagger knobs.
What were you like driving by a bunch of black people and thought, man, so cool if I just roll down the window and shout something racist.
No. I think I was frustrated about something.
Black people walking around like they own the place. Acting as though they're entitled to something.
We are the worst people.
We gave you civil rights.
Look, they can have all the cotton they want.
I love how the people who say that, like, have no concept of the irony of that statement.
Hello, French tinkler.
Now look at this guy, Jesus Christ.
You never know who's going. Your jacket is so low texture. Yeah, all sorts
of sickos can use the internet. Is he like a part-time Uncle Sam impersonator?
Like, I cannot figure out what is with his jacket. Nico, what do you do? I do a lot of things. What's your job? Oh my god, thank god you're not some craggy-faced Russian. Thank god you're like some handsome dreamboat. Like, who? Mr. John sounds like I do not understand, like, everyone's attraction to Nico.
What type of man do you want to meet?
One with a lot of money. Do you
Did you see
Tony?
That portrait he had on Love Me?
Gay Tony.
I'll tell you a secret. Why does this guy move around his arms like a puppet from the Rankin Fast Professionals?
He's a character in a Grand Theft Auto game.
Yeah, but he's moving around like a stop motion puppet.
What are you talking I really want to know who designed this costume. You know who I pay this and virtual don't pay costume. Back. Fuck you,
bitch. You George W. Bush. You can't tell me
shit about who I am. I'm just here to do a job. People in this world need to work.
You got a bad I do like you and this thing. I need to start incorporating that into my everyday speech.
Punch that shit.
I didn't realize I didn't have my gun equipped. Oh no. Got some collateral damage.
He's all right, folks.
Walk it off, son.
Finish the job. Uh-oh, somebody's got a problem.
Better drive away.
Oh, I thought that said Blackula after for a second.
Nico Bellic has found
Blackula. Can you edit the game next to change every instance of Brucey to Blackula?
Yes.
You know, it wouldn't make any sense, though, because you're calling him in the daytime, and obviously,
he's in his black cave.
Shit, I don't think I still I don't think I have SA text in it anymore. I'm going to download it again.
There, obviously, like your dog. Let me just
shit.
Inject some testosterone. I kind of like forgot.
My impersonator completely fell apart.
It did. Kind of like your ability to do arithmetic.
Oh, yes. You got that in that one.
or his ability to complete just come. Oh, it's a beautiful day.
It's a beautiful day in Liberty City.
Oh,
who is this woman? She is much better than that game show host. GPS.
Oh.
Wait, you can choose different voices?
No, it's just...
Different cars have different voices.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, the last car with a speaking GPS was like Rodney Dangerfield.
What?
Was it like Rodney Dangerfield in Back to School?
He was like, I don't know.
They should get celebrities to do GPS voices.
Or was it more they do?
Really?
Is it more like Rodney Dangerfield in the movie Rover Dangerfield?
I was about to do the same.
I gotta watch that again.
I would like a GPS voiced by John Malkovich. Turn left at this intersection.
So it'd be sort of like your car was being John Malkovich.
I love that movie so much.
Nico, why don't you know Love Me No More? Yo, go back and ramp that car, you motherfucker.
I can't. The
God
ramp things aren't down to the ground.
Why would they do that? Hate that.
It's because they...
To try and prevent us from LPing the game.
Best fun.
They just want to stop my ramp-phoria.
But they have...
Your ramp-gasm.
Ho ho.
Ho ho ho. And what's your name, little boy?
Black Tumbler.